Hey, this is Nathan Tabor with Handling Life. I hope you're doing well. You know, this is an interesting time, an unprecedented time in our history. I've never been through this, and I'm sure you haven't. There's so much, you know, stress and anxiety and things that we don't know, the unknown, which can lead to depression and conflict. And I was doing my devotions, and I like ran across 1 Thessalonians 5:18. And to be honest with you, it made me feel guilty a little bit. It really burdened me that I had really been focusing on, you know, what wasn't going right in my business, or what wasn't going right in Jordan's business, or, you know, how was this going to happen, or how was that going to happen? And here this Bible verse says, in everything give thanks. In everything. Coronavirus or no coronavirus. Sickness, loss of job, loss of company. It doesn't give an and, but, or. It says in everything give thanks. So I sat down and I started writing down what I was thankful for. Of course, I'm thankful for my salvation. I'm thankful for my wife and my daughter and my family and my food. Kind of the top shelf things, right? But then I went on with it. What else am I thankful for? I'm thankful for clean clothes. I'm thankful for a roof over my head. I'm thankful for, you know, the food that I'm able to eat. I'm thankful for the HVAC, and I'm thankful for clean water. And the list just kind of starts going on and on and on. Things that I know that are there, but in a period, in a time like this, I've really started to look at that and say, hey, God, thank you for this. Thank you for providing me with these things. Thank you for the technology to be able to communicate with others and share with others. So I got a challenge for you. I'm calling it hashtag count your blessings. As the song says, count your blessings, name them one by one, and I will spare you from singing because that would be cruel and unusual punishment. But what has God done for you? What is God doing for you? What are the things that you could count? And whether you tell others about them or not, you don't have to. But in your heart, are you telling God that you're thankful for those? And if you won't share them with others, be an encouragement to others instead of focusing on what we don't have or the uncertainty of what's going on. Because remember, as Christians, we might be, you know, in a time of uncertainty here, but we're not uncertain about our future. We're not uncertain about where we're going. And that's joy, right? That's what James, find joy in all circumstances. This is not our final home. This is not our final stop. So I want to encourage you. I want to challenge you. Will you take this challenge and start counting your blessings? And if you won't, share it with others. Take this video and share it. Or make it your own. Make your own video and encourage your friends and your families and your coworkers and people you go to church with to do the same, and then show others. There is a way in this time in our society and what's going on in our world, there is a way to have joy and to have contentment and to have peace in your life, but it doesn't come from material things. It doesn't come from having enough toilet paper. It doesn't come from having a stocked fridge. It's only going to come through our relationship with God, and it's only going to come through keeping our focus on what He has done for us, and like Thessalonians says, to give thanks in everything. So I hope you'll take this challenge. I hope you will take the hashtag, count your blessings, and let's make it across the board, across the internet, that people see and hear from us, and maybe they'll ask, what's different about him? What's different about her? Why are they saying what they're so thankful for in such a time as this? And maybe that's the seed. Maybe that's the seed that the Holy Spirit uses to lead them to a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. I'm Nathan Tabor with Handling Life. I hope you'll pray for this ministry. Hope you'll pray for me. I hope you'll pray for others. Pray for our doctors and our nurses and our service members, our policemen, our firemen, all those who are serving our society. And I hope you'll pray for each other. And please know that even if I don't know you, I'll be praying for you. God bless.